Ugh, water. It's what's for dinner. It smells like worms. Yeah, it smells like worms. You know what I'm talking about? When you got the window open and you got a glass of water and it's sitting there. And, I don't know, the earth kind of hits the cup and kind of saturates the water. And next thing you know, you take a drink and your damn water smells like dirt and worms. I think someone out there will understand what I'm talking about. I'm barely speaking. I don't feel very good. I'm going to try to make this video, I don't know, I'd say short, because I'm going to play a little bit of Mass Effect, as you can see. Level 12, whoop-de-ding-dong. But this is part 8, Mass Effect Andromeda. But before I start to play, I'm going to show you an expensive toy that I didn't need to buy, but I wanted to buy, and I can't help myself because I'm just that kind of guy. I always seem to rhyme, but I don't mean to. Yeah, that's a curse of mine. But I don't feel good. I don't know, I think I said already that I got food poisoning, but food poisoning is not going to stop me from showing you this cool thing I got from Best Buy now, is it? It's the Mass Effect Andromeda Collector's Edition. That is, I believe, Scott Ryder himself on the front, dude. Fuck his sister, who cares? I haven't even seen her yet. She's still asleep. I guess it goes either way if you pick the male or the female. But this is the remote control RC. It retails at $299. Fucking $99. Little too much, if you ask me, but whatever. I had to have it. Anyways, here is the back of the box. You get a little shot of what you get in here. It tells you what it does. It's got lights, it's got sounds, it's got a remote. Well, you gotta have a smartphone to have the remote, but you get a steelbook case, no game, because they don't like to give games anymore with these things, because they feel that maybe you're a sucker and you're going to buy it. And I guess I'm calling myself a sucker, but, you know, I didn't pay full $200 for it. I'll be honest with you, I got a bit of a discount, a decent discount, let's say a birthday discount. So, that was an empty box, because I've already opened up this thing a little bit ago for the first time. I've been sick, and I finally got to see it. So, I checked it out, so I had it ready to go, because I don't have a setup to actually show you guys the car zipping around and everything. But I took it for a spin, and I'm pleased with it. I like it. So, you open up the box, and you're met with this, which is a pretty cool slip case for it. It's got the Tempest on it. Sorry, I never know which way to go with my camera, right? And then, you know, the other side has just a design, Tempest design on it too. Once again, I fucked up going where I need to go with the camera. And the number 5, because, you know, we all know what that's about, right? Anyways, mega glare, you can see the monitor that's right next to me on there. So you take the slip case off, and you're met with, you're not going to believe this, you're never gonna believe it, another box. Okay, the box is, I guess, the box itself. This one here, I'll try and get this for you. I think it has a hinge, right? And it fucking stinks, god damn. It's got like these fabric hinges on it, whatever, kind of cool. Mold to, for the car to sit in, and some foam to protect it. And in the box, you got this awesome limited edition USB cable. Not really limited, but you know what I mean. I threw it. Sorry. I hope no one's mad about that, but I got a million of those. There was a little antenna. It just looks like a piece of plastic. And then there's this. This is cool. I mean, it still doesn't really, to me, with the car and the box and this steelbook case, which is pretty neat. You can see that. Fucking glare. You can see that it says Pathfinder right there. It's got the ship. It's embroidered on this. Oh shit, I dropped it, dude! On a steelbook. And then the back says, the Andromeda Initiative, bro. Watch out, coming at you strong. You can see the reflection of the fucking recording going on. Oh well. Live in the studio. Slash not a studio. And then the inside of the case has the Nomad just kind of coasting on some sand planet. Pretty cool. I like steelbooks. This is a nice one. I like it. So anyways, I took the car out already, or the Nomad six-wheeler, and here it is. I'm gonna hold it up. You guys got a shot, side shot of that bad boy. I'm gonna peek under it so I can see what the fuck I'm doing. And of course, if you watch my videos, you know I scale everything to Metal Mario. Yep. So you can see, as I peek underneath it, because I can't see what I'm doing, Metal Mario is about to get obliterated by the Nomad. Here's the top of the Nomad. Metal Mario by the wheel. You get the idea. Decent size. It's got a lot of weight to it, which is good. It's got a, I believe, a lithium inside, rechargeable, so you don't have to worry about replacing batteries. It's got a lot of detail. I got the app on. That's the music you hear. It's just like the app that plays when you turn it on to control your Nomad. The back lights are lit up. It's ready to rock and roll. It's got back lights. It's got front lights. It's got independent steering. We're going to pair it, and I'm going to show you a little bit of the features of this. Like I said, I can't zip it around. Let me get my fingers out of the way. What was that wheel going to turn to? It might. So when you zip it around, there's sound effects that come off the phone that you'll hear. You heard it, right? We'll turn them off. It's got a camera, so you can actually see what's going on. I'll show you my phone. It's literally pointing at the monitor right now, so that way you can see this is what you see. Well, with minus the glare. We'll move the camera a little bit over here. You can barely see my Doom poster. You can see my Opeth flag, whatever. I like that band. I don't know if anybody knows them or not, but I'm pretty BA. So anyways, you can see the camera moving around. It's an HD camera. It looks great. It can take screenshots. It can do video recording, or you could just turn it off if you don't want it on. And then you can actually turn lights on, like if you go into a dark area. My controller went to sleep. What a fucking surprise. Like if you go into a dark area with the car and you got the camera on, you want to see. I don't know if you guys are going to get this, but this button turns on a set of lights. There they are, the front lights. And this button turns on the top lights. That'll be up here. Up here. Yep. So you can see the lights turned on. It's pretty neat. It's pretty fucking fast. I'll crank it. It actually gets up and goes. And it's got independent steering front and back. Let's see if I can get a shot of that. Yeah. That's probably pretty much all I can really show you. It takes a standard charging USB-A cable. Nothing special. I'm sure you guys have like a million of those laying around. So, but yeah, I'd show you the phone, but there's so much reflection on it. Basically, it's got controls. You can trim it. Shows you the battery life, camera controls, and of course the lights, which I will turn off and show you that. And push a button to turn the front lights off and the top lights off. Pretty cool. Yeah, $199.99. It might be worth your money. There's 10,000 of them. I've only seen 1,000 people download the app, so that might tell you something about, you know, how well it's selling, I guess. I mean, if no one downloads the app, but then you can just probably imagine that people are trying to scalp them too because they went up about $100. But I don't have to worry about that shit because I got mine. Fuck you and your $100 inflation price for my Nomad, man. I bought it because I'm a big Mass Effect fan. I always have been. I love the original trilogy. People talk a lot of shit about Mass Effect Andromeda. I thought it was a little hit or miss when I first fired it up, but it's getting good, and we'll continue some gameplay here. Get it all ready for you, that way it's not blazing loud for you. But that was the Nomad RC. Yeah, sorry I can't zip the fucker around, but in the future maybe I can do a video. But by the time that happens, you guys had seen probably 100 videos, but maybe not. I've only seen 2 or 3. And they don't really show you any of the features, how the buttons work or what they do or the lights turn on. They just kind of show you it zipping around, which kind of sold me on it, but oh well. So we're going to go into Mass Effect Andromeda Part 8 here in just a moment at the 10-minute mark. Make sure I got this all good and well. And switch over to the old... Oh, it's already on there. Okay, so I'm going to play this damn game. Or you know what? I'm going to level my character up first. Let's do that. You guys get to see the game start from the boring old level up, which I haven't played this in a week. So I'm just like, what do I even have? I don't even know what I want to use. Low damage, everything else is good. That's what I have equipped, the M8 Avenger. Nah, fuck all that. Melee. Didn't I get something new? Oh yeah. Remnant Cryo Gauntlet. Ultra rare melee weapon. I found that shit. What's it do? I mean, is it any different than these? There's no damage output. Wait, 275, 400, 226 melee. Why the fuck would I want to use that? Anyways. I feel like I left something out. I feel like, I don't know, like there was a part of that I didn't show you because that's all you get is the car and the steel book and the box, which kind of makes you feel like, you know, after you get it, but it doesn't make me feel that way. It's a nice showpiece, but they do have the diecast model that's $100 less, and it's the same size, and it actually does more in the sense of like a showcase piece. I'll show you here, this part here, this cockpit area, actually pops up and the doors come up and it has a whole console with like the controls and circuitry that light up blue. And this drone back here, the mining drone, that'll pop up too. You can pop that up and I believe it has a light ring that goes around it. So it's almost like you start to ask yourself, is the RC even worth it? I mean, I get to zip it around for $100 more. But, I don't know, I think for $100 just to have this on your shelf as a collectible piece in the diecast, you know, the diecast version, it has more visual, you know, aesthetically pleasing things to it. But, I think I like this better still. But who knows, no one's buying the diecast one, so wait it out. If no one, you know, buys it enough and it's just sitting there, they got six at my Best Buy, so hell, you know. Maybe they'll knock them half off, and yeah, I'd buy a diecast model. I'm ranting. I need to play this game. So, let's see. Well, what the fudge? Ooh, God, I wish I wasn't so tired. Okay. Skills. I chose to be a combatant. I'm going to shrink my window here so you guys can see more of the game. Bada boom, bada bing. Okay. I'm also going to kick back a little bit because, like I said, I don't feel good. And really want to make this video. I'm going to move my mic here. Might be a little noisy. Apologize for that, I guess. Not really. And I'm going to kick back a little bit. Oh, because I am really stiff, man. Oh, cool, cool, cool. Omni grenade. I haven't gotten that yet. Should probably start putting some points in my weapons. I don't know. I gotta do a couple adjustments here because I'm sitting farther back. A little bit more. That looks about right. Yeah, it looks about good. Just making sure everything's running all right. Oh, God. Okay. Are you too hot over there?
No.
All right. It cooled down for some reason. You feel that?
Yeah.
Rank 2 is locked. Whatever. Requirements rank 1. I didn't buy it yet. Increase maximum health with each skill point invested in the combat skill group. Yeah, sure. Up to 3 weapons can be equipped at once and carrying capacity is increased. Fuck yeah. Get out of town. Increase combat power damage with each skill point invested in the combat skill group. Yes, please. Increase melee damage with each skill point invested in the combat. Yeah. Increase combo detonation damage. Yeah, we'll come back to that. I can't decide what weapons I want to roll with. I like assault rifles, I guess. And shotguns. Let's look at the powers. The powers that be. Pole? I forgot I have that. Shockwave. Tech. I wanted to go down the tech route. Infects opponents with an invasive. What's that? VI? Controlled machine swarm that weakens defenses and spreads itself to nearby enemies. That's kind of neat. I invested a point in that already. Increase tech effect duration with each skill point. Improve tech construction health and damage output with each skill point. Restore shields by sapping electromagnetic energy around a target. That's cool. Ah, that might be worth it. That's pretty neat. We'll do energy drain. I like that. Recharge your own shields by sucking it off of somebody else. I can live with that. I got 2 points. Where's invasion? There it is. Boom. Concussive shot, pull, invasion. I'm gonna change. How do I do that? Assign power, energy drain. We're gonna put that here. Engineer unlocked. The engineer profile is now at rank 1. Cool. Sentinel unlocked. Infiltrator unlocked. Explorer unlocked. Damn. Okay. I forgot, do I have to pick one of these or just one? Yes, just one. infiltrators or tech and combat specialists. I like that. That's exactly what I wanted to be. I wanted to use tech and combat, be a combat specialist. Weapon accuracy, weapon stability, tech recharge speed, battlefield awareness, cloak evades. Oh, while evading a brief, cloaking device is activated. Explorer is jack of all trades. Fuck that. Vanguard, aggressive combat style. Close, preferring to close in on enemies and deal heavy damage at short range. Sentinels are unique combatants, bringing a mix of tech and biotics. That's kind of cool. Adept, biotic specialist, engineer, experts in both offense and defensive tech power. An engineer would kind of lock me in to being just, not really lock me in, but it would make me more of a really, really tech-heavy guy. Soldier, I like the guns, I like the damage output, I love concussive shot. So, tech and engineer, that is an infiltrator. It's a mix of being an engineer and a soldier. Infiltrator it is, I think, because I get the best of combat and technology. Which makes it kind of stupid for me to pick that. I mean, why don't I just play fucking Ghost Recon Wildlands if I'm going to do that shit? What am I thinking, Cheryl?
I don't know.
It's not. It's different. God, I always have such a hard time deciding. I was a pure soldier for a while, but that's all I could really be. Okay. Sentinel is tech and biotic. That seems like a weird mix. We can switch it up, so for now, we're going to go with Infiltrator. I've made up my damn mind. Oh, dude, I got a trophy, Jack of all trades, bro. You guys didn't see it pop because my stupid fucking sick ass with my leg up was in the way. God, I don't feel good. Yeah, here's what I was trying to explain earlier. You see that fucking, that dash? That is in the actual diecast model, and all that's visible. That lights up, those doors open. You see this, Cheryl? In the diecast model, watch this. In the diecast model of the Nomad, the doors open, and that lights up. The whole console. And then the mining drone in the back pops up, too. So it's almost like they gave the diecast model more attention, you know? Because the lights light up, too. Everything, it's got more to it than the fucking RC does. Well, it doesn't have a camera or anything, but still. My ass will buy a diecast model if they go down to $50. Right?
Yeah.
You're like, don't do it. You're nuts. She really doesn't want me to buy it. I might not listen, though. I usually don't. Alright. I gotta give my squad some shit. They gotta go to the bar Squads. Remember that place?
No.
Oh. Yeah, me neither. I don't even care about what my fucking AI has. I mean, she just gets in on them. I mean, I'll boost her shields. She needs it. She just kind of just, I don't know, I don't like that skill where they dash in, it's stupid. It's like, then you're like up front and you gotta have all these other abilities to make it work, I don't know. Havoc Strike, I'll boost his shields, his health. Which doesn't matter because the AI never gets in trouble, at least I haven't experienced it. 3 points. Direct damage with the grenade, yeah. Why is skill still lit up? Who's got a fucking point?
Cora.
Oh, big deal. She can't even use it. They're like, hey, make sure you use that point that you can't use right now. Okay. Whatever. Alright, so you guys got to see a boring-ass part of Mass Effect where I was, like, going through my skills and shit. And the game's still kind of fucking too bright. I don't know. It's pissing me off. I got it into a PS4 Pro, and I can't just record the damn thing. I have to disable HDCP, and then I did that, and it's just a mess. Like, I don't know. It just doesn't seem right. It doesn't look that good, and I don't know. Whatever. Maybe I'll actually start playing this game a little bit for you. Oh, cool. I cloaked when I evaded. That's a new ability I have. That's pretty neat. I can get behind that. Oh yeah, I can carry 3 weapons now because I'm awesome. And it'll be a sniper rifle. Heck yeah. Let me take a look at what we got here. I'm sticking with the Krogan hammer. Shotgun. Only have one. M8 Avenger. Yeah, it's still the best. Looks like my chest has a spot. I can't see around the dumb monitor. Fusion mod of shielding. 50% max shield. Negative 50% max health. Oh my god. How's that good? I guess more shields takes less time for them to deplete them? Can't talk. Was that him?
Yeah.
What kind of cry was that?
Weird. Probably scared.
Poor guy.
He's in there by himself in the dark, you know.
Yeah. Boost life support capacity allows the user to survive hazardous environments longer outside the Normandy. No effect on combat. Shot stuns enemies for deal large bonus damage to shields, last for the next 3 clips of the current equipped gun. We're gonna go with disruptor ammo, I think. Yes, we'll see. Okay, everybody back to the Nomad.
Sorry, commandos. I hear a lot of things.
You hear, or you watch low-budget action films?
Either way, huntresses hunt. They sabotage. They do assassinations.
All officially sanctioned.
And that was all fine with you?
Yeah. Hunt down anti-Citadel fanatics, or let crisis response mop up the blood later. That's not a choice.
I don't even think you can run over the bugs.
Thank you.
TV's still way too fucking bright. No, you motherfucker. Who the fuck did that? Liam? You dumbass motherfucker. Yeah, this picture is still really bright. Wish I knew why. Oh, God. I'll try one more time to fix it. Oh, God. That helped. I'm really sick. You guys can probably tell. You're like, damn, that motherfucker needs to go to bed. Yeah, I kind of do. Well, not really. I changed jobs, so I could stay up late again like I like to, but I did not plan on getting sick this weekend. I had the whole fucking weekend off, and it was thwarted by getting sick. Oh, I really do feel like shit. That's why I'm being all lazy.
Good work back there.
Back making where? A really, really shitty video. Where are you like?
There's a whole galaxy behind us.
I need to fucking look at the map and figure out what it is I'm doing. Okay. I can't even remember where I've been in this damn game. I think whites mean that you haven't been there. So, we're gonna check this area out. You can't run the bugs over. It's so stupid. That's a pretty neat ability.
Get to a research station, see what we've got.
Well, that was easy enough. I swear when I was first playing this game, when like the first or second day that it came out, there were a lot of bugs. And I'm not talking about the ones that you can't run over. I'm talking about just... I was playing the game and I got... I think it was like my Let's Play 3. 2 or 3, I don't know. I got stuck and I'm like, well, I'm not stuck. And I knew I wasn't stuck. And I was getting a little frustrated because... I'm gonna shoot that. I got distracted. I was getting frustrated because I knew I wasn't fucking stuck. I'm like, no, I'm doing everything it wants me to do, but, you know, it was a bug, and I wasn't stuck, it was just fucking, the game itself was stuck. Like, but I'm pretty sure I tried to scan these areas before when I first played, and I couldn't do it, and now I can. Because I was like, why can I not scan what it's telling me to scan? But now I can. Keep waiting for the Nomad to like blow up. Oh, what the fuck? Oh my God, the Nomad landed in some water or something. that means it's the end all be all.
We're dead.
It's all over.
Radiation levels have spiked, Pathfinder.
What the? Pathfinder, that body.
A scan might help us figure that out.
What body? Oh yeah, if you want to climb, you gotta raise it. Yeah, raise the lift kit, bro. Huh? Yeah, I'll get it for you. I don't care if he's crying. People are just gonna have to deal with it.
Radiation levels normal. Life support is back online. Radiation levels have spiked, Pathfinder.
Readjusted. God, I feel like shit. What time is it? Not bad, I guess. I'll have to get up for a while. Being lazy. Kicking back. Because if I don't, I might fucking puke. I literally cannot sit forward. I sit forward right now. I feel sick. This side, I can't seem to understand where I scanned something. Right here is an area. It doesn't say anything. It means there's an objective there. It's probably a glitch, because you know how that's been, right? Glitches fucking everywhere. Trying to do something.
Cat ahead. They appear to be fighting a Krogan.
Is that Drac?
I wanted to go here. I didn't want to go over here yet, but whatever. Damn it all.
Cat ahead. They appear to be fighting a Krogan.
Is that Drac?
Can I run him over? Yes.
Ryder, about time you joined the party.
I think that's it.
Thank you. was fun.
You're telling me?
You could really handle yourself, kid. And I hear you're the one to thank for clearing up the sky. Had your number all wrong.
So the clouds parted, and these Kett look pretty keeled over. Maybe us humans can pull our weight after all.
Well, you can, clearly. But there's a lot to do before I'd be that smug about it. You know what? I'm gonna ignore my gut and join up. This fight was good, and we can do it again. And before you go say you don't need a Krogan, believe me, you do.
Never said I didn't want one.
That's what I said.
That's kind of a chintzy segue into him joining my crew. That's it. I'm gonna stop following my gut and join your crew right now.
Detecting above normal radiation levels.
No, nothing else to it. That was just it. Whatever.
Radiation levels normal.
This is where we'll build our new outpost. A real beginning.
Prepping deployment order. You must choose what purpose this new outpost will serve.
The Nexus doesn't get a say?
Resources are at a crisis point. Protocol states this judgment call falls to the Pathfinder. With current supplies, you could build a military outpost, focusing on defense and militia training. Alternatively, a scientific outpost could advance the initiative's research and discoveries.
I'm choosing this outpost's direction for decades. Maybe centuries.
That is the prime responsibility of a Pathfinder. Be advised that the first outpost placed by a Pathfinder will be a statement in itself. Fair or not, your choice will represent the initiative and its intentions in Andromeda. Consider carefully.
A military outpost or a scientific outpost? What do you think? The outpost that I, like, put here is gonna be what they do for a very long time.
Scientific.
Yeah, there's a lot to, like, discover and learn about this planet. But the Kett is also, like, constantly trying to fight you. We'll go with scientific.
Prioritize research and discovery. That's our foundation. And our future.
Orders prepped. Ready on your signal.
Andromeda Initiative, this is Ryder, Pathfinder.
EOS is ready for deployment.
Copy that. Outpost block inbound. And ready as hell.
She looks a lot better. Remember her makeup?
Oh, yeah.
They took it away. And then I think they sent their eyes back farther in the heads and they were so cold. And they took all
August
the dumb makeup away.
Operational head for this block. Mayor now, I suppose. We're ready to make the most of what you delivered.
It took a lot of people to get us this far. That's the work you'll continue.
I hear that. Prodromos. That's what we're calling her.
They're eager. I haven't seen eager for months. Eos is far from golden. But now it's a producer. A real and reasonable first step. They think you did the impossible. The Nexus. I warned them. Hoping was irresponsible. You proved me wrong, Pathfinder.
What are you playing at? Seems like being my friend is suddenly valuable.
Fair assumption. The reality, Ryder? You bought us time. But one outpost on a long-shot planet won't stop us from starving. You already have a lead on something else?
The nav point from the vault.
Now it gets complicated. The others are ready to officially sanction your efforts, to be a part of your success. We all want the initiative to succeed. But after failing for so long, no one agrees on how to do it. Be aware, that's all.
I don't know what to say. You're just as manipulative. Arguing is pointless. I can handle myself. Or whatever helps the initiative.
I can handle myself.
Don't worry. I majored in Gladhanden during Pathfinder training.
We're led by the best. Talk to Bradley. Later we'll go over the extended job of Pathfinder. Until then. Tan's waiting on the Nexus.
We're up there. The fuck are we doing up here? Anyways.
Life support restored.
Sorry it came to this, Pathfinder.
I really hope all those scientists will be safe out here.
We came to explore and learn. That's who we are. I keep wondering what our scientists will cook up for Eos.
Well, not much is going on in the game right now. Just, what do you want to call it? I don't know, I cleared the sky on this planet. They named the settlement. I chose what research I wanted it to have. I went with scientific. Not going to drag the video out any longer. It's almost an hour. Don't like to go over an hour. I have before, and it's probably not too wise. And there's not much going on, so won't be too action-oriented anymore for the night. But that was Mass Effect Andromeda Part 8. I feel like I got more sick as time went on. So, anyways, you saw the Nomad unboxing. Pretty cool. And you saw some of Mass Effect. Oh, God. Every time I burp or something, it just, that's horrible. But anyways. Thanks for watching. That was Part 8. And Part 9 will be here sooner than later. I'm guessing sooner. Alright, I'm gonna get some rest. I feel like shit. Thanks for watching, and take care.